Oh, I know what you're doing. And it still says I'm playing PsyOps. That's not true. It's false advertising. Alive. It's really, really weird to see only two save slots in a in my Resident Evil 4 save screen. That is a lot of stuff. It's a lot of rifle ammo. Right. Oh, this is the downside of leaving it a while. I really could. What am I doing? Have I killed the Garrador yet?
Wait.
I don't think so. No. Okay, I haven't done this bit yet. All right. Do I have a capacity upgrade? No, I've just got one. All right, so I'm not going to be able to cheese the Garrador 100%, but still be able to cheese him fairly easily. This is unprofessional. Man. Old man memory. Seriously. Give me your money, Sadler. Only a chump would hide their money behind a picture frame anyway. Have you never seen, like, a movie ever? That's where everybody hides their money. I really, really want the stock for this. But that means it's going to take up more space than a pistol, which is not efficient. I really wish there was a way you could just reset, like, all of your items when you complete the game. Just, like, reset your case, reset your health. Right, we want to save them. I don't have room for that. That's a full heal at this point. Yeah, I'm going to have to go upgrade that.
Follow me.
Come on, Ashley, let's go. I really wish, though, when you had a pistol, there was a pistol in the holster on his leg. That really bugs me. RE5 actually had that. Sit down. Oh man, that hip fire aiming is just. I could have swore I'd killed everybody in that room, but never mind. Okay.
Got some rare. What are you buying? Is that all strength? Thank you.
Have I even got my free Punisher yet? Yeah, I must have done. I don't actually remember doing that, but. That was horseshit. Sit down, wanker. God damn it. Alright, I'm gonna have to use that on me. I'll use the green herb that I get out of the Garrador room on Ashley, and then I better not get hit in that hallway room.
Wait.
Right, we'll leave you there for now. There we go. Right, that'll heal Ashley up just fine. What a dumbass. Oh, come on, that got him. I didn't walk back far enough. Sorry, Ashley, but I just need health now.
Wait.
What? That was right in the... You bitch. That was right in the weak spot. That was weird. Hey, mercenary. That guy cheated. That guy cheated. Alright then. This is going to be pretty interesting with a wounded Ashley. Point. It's rude. Where's your buddy? Aw, oh, I missed. Alright, I need to save at least 2 shots of that. Don't trip. I'm so funny. I've probably said that every time I've played this bit as well. Behave. Explode. Explode faster. God damn it. You just can't get the staff. Right, I'll have that.
Follow me.
I should probably reload this. Man, I'm at one, like, there's quite a lot in here that's going to be able to one-shot me at that health. There we go. Okay, how am I doing for rifle ammo? 43 spare rounds. Okay. Fuck that. I'm gonna blame my controller for that one. There we go. Fuck you. Whoa! He sponged it! What a bitch. Right. Screw you. There we go. That's all I wanted. Right. I need to go to the, I need to just go straight here and get Ashley this green herb. Fall over! Put me down! Oh, this bit's not going well. Oh, didn't even think about it. Ashley, get up. There we go. I do love that animation. Oh, fuck you. What are you doing? That was lucky. Give me health, you bitch. Ah. Oh, that frame rate. Xbox One, people. Godlike. Probably gonna have to do a bit more killing here than I would like. Ashley, come on, move. Ooh, that was close. Oh, this is gonna be hard. Ashley, move. Ah, this bit without a shotgun, man. It's never not a huge pain in the arse.
Wait.
Are you kidding me? She's gonna get picked up. Oh shit, there was a shield guy there. Son of a bitch. Ah, man, that went bad at the start, though. I should probably just run past these guys, to be honest. Right, fuck you. Right. Let's go. Alright, that's fine. It took a lot of my ammo, though. I'm working on it. Fuck it. Don't follow me. Yes, it worked. God, it's like crash the game almost. Look at this tough guy. Thinking he's the shit. Fuck you. Oh shit. All right. Wow, that actually went like disturbingly well. All right, I need that green herb. They're just not gonna let me get that, are they? I can't remember what. I think it was a review of this game actually. That was actually praising like the port. And was like, yeah, like the frame rate is super solid and everything. It's like, dude, no, it fucking isn't. Like, it just is not. Like, the frame rate's okay if you never do anything. You know? Like, if you never ever do anything, the frame rate's fine. If you do anything when there's a lot of people on screen, like, it fucking dies. I really need to get an opportunity to reload my rifle here, too. Oh, bonus green herb. Who's. What's behind me? Ah. Oh no, there is a shield guy. You should be able to just leave the bullets on the floor so they trip over them. Like marbles. This dickhead is always waiting here. Alright. This is going to be a tricky reload. I'll just get this. That should do it. Fuck off.
Follow.
Let's go. I hope that hurt. Fuck you. Ah, okay. Of course, none of them give me any ammo. Ooh, I've still got a flash grenade. That's going to come in handy. Come on, Ashley. Get to work. Okay. This could very well crash the game. But hey ho. That's gonna hit me. Ow! I might not have needed to use that, but I didn't want to risk it. And I was really hoping that I'd catch all of them. Don't throw that at me. Whoa! Okay. Ah, oh, that took one of my incendiaries. I'm not happy about that. Ah, oh, that bit went okay, I suppose. I'd really want to try and get the first aid spray out of this too, but I've got a lot of people to deal with here. And no shotgun. Leon, you'll trigger safety. That is terrible. If you sneezed, you'd like blow a head off. Right, this should be rifle ammo. Oh no, it's the other one. Oh man, I got like a right, I got a right fan club here. Fuck off. What? Yeah. you bitch. Alright. Fucking handgun ammo, are you kidding me? Where's the runner? Oh, what are you doing? Hang on. Right, reload. You absolute dick. Yeah. Dick. I just knew that wasn't gonna kill him. Oh, you're killing me. Sit down. Can probably kiss goodbye to that first aid spray. Although, actually, I might be able to get it. I've got a really bad feeling I've gone to the wrong one. Yay, no, I didn't. Okay, we've got shield guy. Where is he going? Die. Hey, let's go. All things considered, that didn't go too badly. I managed to get out with two healing items. It did kind of do a number on my grenades, which sucks. I got plenty of rifle ammo though. It didn't use too much rifle ammo, and I should have another capacity upgrade for that relatively soon. Yeah. Hey, what's up, Faye? God, this hip firing is killing me. It just seems so weird. This is a grenade. I think this is a grenade. I'm gonna save the target practice thing until the last one, so I can just do it all at once. It's much easier that way. Wait, rifle ammo, give me that. Handgun ammo. Okay, cool. Welcome.
Some rare. What are you buying?
Yep, still got a capacity upgrade for that. Is that old? We'll get firepower and reload speed because it takes like half a year to reload that goddamn thing.
Is that old?
Look how slow that is.
Thank you.
And I think that's it. Yeah, I still got shitloads of treasure. I can't believe I forgot the bloody BSD. That's a blow up. Right. Let's move my grenades. Now, I usually always use a flashbang on the monk room. Clockwork Tales. What's that about, though? Ugh, first death. Gay. Right, let's go. Mobile iOS 100. Oh, fair enough. I've been playing a lot of Dust this past week on Steam. That game is fucking amazing. That was that came out, I think it was 2011, 2012. And that was when I was actually working in games. And that was one of the games that I always thought, you know, when I've got the time, I'm going to come back to this. Because goddamn, that game is something else. All right, let's take care of these. Boom. You're dead. I can't believe I went so long not knowing about that. If you shoot them, like, in the eye with the rifle, it's a one-shot kill every time. Unfortunately, you can see, like, where their drool is, which is nasty. And you just know that the eye is fairly, you know, just directly above that. Shoot, and boom. One shot every time. I didn't know that until this year. Now, hopefully, I can just run past the rest of these fuckers. Because I hate these guys. Ah, so much for that. They can so easily just take you out too. There you are, you little shit. Yep, he's dead. Oh no, that's just water. This is unprofessional fire. Don't jump on me. Don't jump on me. Don't jump on me. Thank you. Yeah, like the bugs are pretty much 2-hit kills. You have to heal after they hit you, otherwise you're dead. If they get you again. And looking to the left makes them far less likely to pounce on you. It's not guaranteed, but it's fairly reliable. Whee! Yeah, I don't think I'm going to bother using my flashbang here. I'm going to make up quite a bit of money on the target practice, so I don't need to go for shitloads of treasure like I usually would. Because I do want to try and get as much money on this run as possible, but... Although, hang on, no, did I get a flashbang? No, I did. Yeah, I can actually still do this. Because there's like 30 grand in this room. Oh no, that didn't go over the edge. Oops, no, don't do that. I can't remember where that goes off. Oh, the red guy got away. That's like the one I really wanted to kill. Oh, well. I like it how one always comes up here first. You shouldn't run on the stairs, people. It's very dangerous. Someone might shoot you in the face with a sniper rifle. And you know, that's just, you know, it doesn't really get much more dangerous than that. And then you might fall down the stairs, look. See? Look at that. You were all running on the stairs. That's like the first thing your parents should teach you. Never run on stairs. Oh, even though it's annoying when they survive, it does seem like just way more painful when they survive the suplex on stairs. Like, that would fucking hurt. So that was, what, like, 7 Welcome. Spinels, I think. That sucked, though. The red guy got away. Some rare thing. What are you buying? Is that old strike? Oh, wow. Oh, I missed a firepower upgrade on that thing. A lot of the castle is kind of tricky without a shotgun. You really, really do need a shotgun for a lot of this stuff. Still doing good on rifle ammo, though. Let's go. That guy is so eager on professional. He always just rushes you. You will die. Guess not. I love that noise when you pick up. You don't run, you hope you're first. That's true. But they died. Ah! Oh. How am I doing for TMP ammo? Oh, I can reload that. Granted, they probably would have been dead anyway. He's another eager beaver. Die! God, I love that noise. Even though I would prefer it if that killed you. This is going to be a little... Oh, he's already running, isn't he? Fucker. You dick. Yeah, he already ran. What happens if I go this way? I feel like I've already tried this, but... Because he comes down here, so... Going? Where are you going? Outsmarted you. I'm a genius. Although I swear I've already tried that and it didn't work the last time I tried that. There we go. Finally, Jesus Christ. Give me your key. That's two suplexes that guy has taken. Two suplexianos. Is that supposed to be just a bit of rope that they have on their robes? Holy shit! That probably should have hit me, but I'll take it. Is there anything... I can't remember if there's anything good in those... I don't think there's anything worth getting in those vases that I left behind. At least I hope there isn't. Oh, Faye, that reminds me. Are you getting Titanfall 2 on release? Because I really like the look of that game. And I might have to get that. It looks so cool. And it actually has a proper campaign this time, so... Because I do want to try out the multiplayer, but... Halo 5 is satisfying my multiplayer needs right now, so. Fuck off. Right, I'll use a herb here just in case I get a bloody scythe thrown at me. Which would not be very good for me right now. Thanks. That's gonna hit me. No, it isn't. Oh, I really thought that was gonna hit me. Thanks, bro. Yeah, I would like to try the... I'm assuming Titanfall's got co-op. I'm assuming the campaign is going to have co-op. So I would like to try that. Because it just looks so cool. Alright, let's get the fuck out of here. I'm off. Bye-bye. Oh, the maze. Skip this on the GameCube. Only in the GameCube version can you do that. Fun fact. I wish there was a like digital version of the GameCube, just because of the speedrun times. Because I think the like everything past the Ultra HD edition, so like Xbox 360 onwards, pretty much. Because of the load times, it has way quicker. Like that's why the speedrun times are so far apart. Like, I think a good 6 or 7 minutes of like the actual GameCube clock is just load times. From what I hear, Fair, I'd probably go with the SteelSeries. Astro headsets are supposed to be pure garbage. So, and I haven't heard anybody say anything bad about SteelSeries ones, so I'd go with them. Astro are just kind of overpriced shit, from what I know. They could be better, but I don't. The last I heard, which was only like a year ago, they weren't very good. So, I need a new freaking Xbox One pad, man, already. I can't believe it. Like, my analog stick is completely fucked on my Xbox One pad. Using a 360 pad right now. Like a, probably at this point, 8 or 9 year old 360 pad. Still working fine. I have original Xbox controllers that are still working. Like, fine and dandy. A year on the Xbox One pad. A year. And that's it. It gives up the ghost. Oh, shit. Don't jump on me, you fuckers. I've gone the wrong fucking way. No, I haven't. Oh, my God. I actually remembered. Okay, that's a stream highlight. I actually remembered where to go in the maze first go. That's the first time that's happened in, like, 10 years. Probably played this game, like, 200 times. I actually went the right way. I fucking hate those dogs, man. But, yeah. I just really begrudge paying as much as they charge for the controllers. They're so expensive. And, like, I wouldn't mind if, you know, you got more than a year out of it. But, like, you know, a year out of a I really am more tempted to buy, like, to buy just a couple of wired 360 pads and just carry on using them. The only downside is I can't use a mic with those, so. But the Xbox One mic's a piece of shit anyway, so. Peripherals, man. Peripherals, they really need to step up their game. PS4 controllers, good. I love the PS4 controller. That's still going strong. But then again, it should be. You know, like, I'm not really giving the PS4 any credit there. Like, it should still be going strong, because the bloody thing's less than a year old. The Xbox One controller's 2 years old. Eh, fair enough. I guess I just play, I don't know, maybe it's the way I play. I play too much Halo. But yeah, like, a year is pretty much all I got out of mine. And right analog stick is completely fucked. But I think it is kind of lucky you draw with controllers. I've had some controllers last less than 6 months. Whereas, I mean, I think I still have a actual PlayStation 1 controller. Not even PS1, like PlayStation 1 controller that still works. Like, works absolutely fine to this day. That thing is at least 20 years old at this point. Yeah, 1996? Yeah. I think I'm remembering that right. Like, getting on for 20 years old, still works. Works like a charm. That's not what I wanted to do. I'll play that one. Bye bye. Fuck that. Right, that's a good stock of rifle ammo too. Is that 5 incendiaries? That's halfway. Oh yeah, I know some of the launch PS4 controllers were completely fucked. I remember reading about that. But yeah, like I got mine. When did I get mine? I got mine probably a couple of weeks after MKX came out, because the PC version was fucked. So I bought a PS4 for that. So I've had my PS4 a lot longer than my Xbox. There was something really cool about the way the sound just cut out then. That was really cool. Wake up, dickhead. But yeah, the PS4 stuff was a bit weird. But I hardly use my PS4 now. It's weird because I play Halo. On the Xbox, obviously, because you can't play it on anything else. But because I'm playing Halo on the Xbox is the thing that's hooked up to the capture stuff, like 99.9% of the time. So to play a PS4 game, I have to, you know, completely redo my capture setup. So even though I actually intended to use the PS4 more, I've been buying games on Xbox because, you know, that's what I use more than anything else. I didn't forget about you. Sorry. Excuse me. Oh no, I don't really need to go down there.
You bitch! Get off! Ow, 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 my face! Oh my god! I just got wrecked! Ah. That's exactly what I've got on my Xbox One pad for you. That exact problem. But it's on the right analog stick. So, like, on this, I'd constantly be doing that. Like, I'm constantly aiming up. That's the issue I've got. Man, I just got absolutely bodied. That was going so well. Right. Let's try that again. You know, speaking of which, I just thought GameCube controllers were the shit. I never had any problems with GameCube controllers. Fuck off. Goodbye. Yeah, that when you get shield bash, that's pretty funny. He just looks like he's wasted. He's like, oh man, I got so messed up last night. He just looks like he's drunk. And he's like passed out.
Leon, I got it.
Oh dear. It's really good attention to detail that his button pops off his waistcoat, though. You know. Just saying. That was a shitty death. Right. Good. I've got really good stock of rifle ammo building up now. I'm trying to build up as much as possible for the island, because it has to function as my shotgun, my magnum, and my rifle. So, I need a lot of rifle ammo. I'm getting to calm your shit. Man, I'm really in the mood to play Dust now. It's got me thinking about Dust. That game's so good. And it reminded me as well, really quickly, of why you just can't use the scope of a game argument anymore after that game came out. That game was made by one guy. Don't shoot her. And it has mechanics that are more solid than games where hundreds of people work on them. That guy made that thing by himself. And it plays as well as it does. You bastard, you made me waste a bullet. I love how, like, just stupid the hitbox on this thing is. Like, the actual crosshair. It pretty much goes until the second dot down. Like, the actual center four dots, that's pretty much the area of effect of the bullet. It's crazy. That's true. Fair, that's very true. That's a good point.
The door's locked, I can't open it!
I'm working on it. Hold your shit. Oh shit. That was bad. Ooh, that blatantly shot her, but, you know, well, it doesn't matter. No one saw that. You ain't shooting me, the bastard. I was watching a speedrun the other day, and like some guy does this entire bit with nothing but grenades. It's so fucking cool. He just throws like three well-placed grenades and just kills everybody. It's awesome. I wish I had the patience to try an actual speedrun of this game, but it just seems so... Like, it seems like you have to get the patterns down just to an extent that I just can't be bothered to do. Like, you know, and it's one of those things where if one thing goes wrong, because you're basically playing a pattern, you're not really playing on the fly. If one thing goes wrong, you're completely fucked. And I kind of had my fill of that playing Karma Runs, so. Never again. That jumper is way too small for her. Seriously. That's got to be like her little sister's jumper.
It just bugs me every time. I mention that every time I play this game, but it really annoys me. Makes no sense. Quick. Oh yeah, there are. Yeah. There are, fair. But the main thing that stuck out to me with Dust was just how solid the actual fighting mechanics are in that game. It was made by one guy. Like, it's, you know, it's not just, I don't mean this in a way to kind of discredit others, but like, you know, for the most part, like, you know, 2D puzzle platformers, there's not a whole lot of mechanics going on where there's actually like a lot of shit happening in Dust, you know, when you actually fight people. And for it to be as solid as it is amazing. It's one of those few games where I really wish they'd bring out a commemorative physical copy edition, just so, like, it's just one of those games where I just wish I could have like that in a case on a shelf. One of those belly free jumpers. Yeah, I suppose. But yeah, I'd love just to have that on my shelf. Just a copy of Dust. It's so good. And the artwork in the game is unreal. It's such a good game. I'm not sure how the, like, Summer of Arcade stuff is tied up, though. Because I know a lot of that stuff, as far as I can recall, I don't think it can actually go onto any other platform because it was made, you know, solely for XBLA. So, I don't know if there's a timestamp on that or anything. Because you can get Dust on PC. I have Dust on PC. You can get Bastion on PC. That was a Summer of Arcade game. What else? Insanely Twisted Shadow Planet, which I need to download on Steam. That was an XBLA game, and that's on Steam. I wish Geometry Wars 2 would come to PC. What else was there? I feel like there's more than that. Pac-Man... Was Pac-Man Championship Edition DX? Summer of Arcade? I don't think it was. That's an amazing game, though. Pretty sure that's on Steam. I can't wait for the Steam sale this Christmas. It's been ages since I've really kind of bought anything on Steam, and I've almost convinced myself that I need a 1070. So I'm gonna get that and then like go ape shit in the Christmas Steam sale. Get hella games. Doom. Need the PC version of Doom. Because Doom is awesome. I bought The Witcher yesterday, the first one. And man, that is one old school fucking PC game. Like, doing like melee combat with the mouse is so weird. I don't know if the game actually has any gamepad support, but I tried to play it with the 360 pad and like just nothing happens, so I don't think it's got that. But I didn't really expect it to. Cool, thanks Ashley. Right, well that can go because we can't use them. That can go. I'm going to have to throw everything away. Oh dear. Is it worth going back to the treasure room? It's not really, is it? No. Nah, it's not really worth it. I'd sell the Magnum, and I don't really need that money. I can't pick that up. I could do some TMP ammo, actually. The next capacity upgrade's not for a long time, so. I still need to get round to doing another bloody Master Ninja speedrun. It's been like 3 months since Evo, and I haven't managed to try that once yet. That's how you know you played this game too much. I didn't even need to wait for the dot on that one. I knew he was there. Yeah, I think you would have to. Like, I don't really mind it on the mouse. Like, it's okay. I've got a nice mouse, so. But yeah, so it's okay. It's a good game though. I'm liking it so far. It's just really, really fucking dated. You know, like that sort of stuff doesn't usually bother me all that much, but this one, you know, I am noticing it quite a bit. You know, and I've got The Witcher 2 locked and loaded on Steam. I got that in a Steam sale, like. I think the year it came out, it was on sale for like £3 on Steam, and I'd heard like really good stuff about it. And I thought, well, you know, for £3, I might as well buy it. You know, as you do, as you want to do on Steam. And I just never played it, never got around to playing it. So, ah, you fucker. I should have shot him. And The Witcher 3 is actually currently on sale on Steam right now. I think it's like £16. But I'll wait till I've played 1 and 2. Because I imagine The Witcher 3 will be in the Christmas sale. And I might be able to get it for, like, you know, £5 or something. Which would be cool. Steam, man. You gotta love them cheap games. Oh, have you got Gears 4, by the way, Fayo? Because I need some people to try Horde mode out with. I really want to try Horde. Right, that's not entirely done with the castle, but not far off. Oh, I didn't know that. That's cool. I haven't actually tried any of the backwards compatibility stuff yet on Xbox One. It's the interface is just so goddamn slow. It really bugs me. Yeah, I need to double check that. Is Pac-Man Champ Edition on Steam? Okay, well if it is, I don't own it. That needs to be rectified. Because if it is, I need to get that game. Because once I've... I'm trying to think what I've got left on 360. I've got a couple of runs left to do on 360. And then that's pretty much it. And then the 360 will probably go away for a bit. Shit. I was looking for a cheaper offer on the code version. Oh, you mean the digital copy.
Right. Welcome.
What are you? Can I rev my rifle? Yay! Free ammo!
Thank you.
What have I got left in my... I've only got 14 rounds left, so yeah, I need to upgrade that. Is that a... There we go. Yeah, Gears 4 is good though, man. Campaign's really good. Really, really enjoyed the campaign. Right, let's go. I'm just eager to try out Horde mode with the class-based system it has now, which I gotta admit, just on the surface, I'm a bit like, yeah, like I did kind of like that, you know, you just played it however you wanted to play it, but you never know, it could be good. Great stuff. Oh, I hate this bit. On the surface, it should be so simple and just, you know, if you miss one shot, like, it just sends everything off. Oh, nice. Good stuff, Fair. Nice. Good shit.
I highly recommend saving up some rec points if you can, because the first time you open a shitload of gold packs, it's magical. If, like me, you'll probably just get like a billion Warthog certifications. Shit. Yeah, that's what I got the first time. I think I got like 7 or 8 Warthog certifications. Boom. Oh, the frame rate is so bad on this version, man. Fucking terrible. Alright, that was okay. Managed to get through it with 2 flash grenades. Hey, Chris. I'm good, man. How are you? I feel like it's been a while since you stopped by. Or it could just be a while since I streamed. I haven't been streaming much lately. Fucking work, man. Work and non-work shit. Doesn't leave a lot of time for the video games, which sucks.
Follow me.
Let's go. Right. Hang on. I need to check if Pac-Man is on Steam. Ah, yeah. There's DX Plus, but that's not the version I want. Because that added a load of shit that I didn't really like. I just like the Xbox 360 version, just Championship Edition DX. No bullshit. BGM1 soundtrack for life. That's the best piece of music ever. Bunch of beam rifle certs and armors, emblems, etc. Fair enough. Yeah, the armor thing kind of sucks.
Wait.
I still haven't got any Phaetons, by the way, Fayo. Still. I've opened, like, over 60 gold packs. Not a single goddamn Phaeton since getting my certifications. Such dumb shit, man. It's the last vehicle kill commendation I need. And I just cannot get any goddamn Phaetons. It's so annoying. I've got so many tanks. Like, you wouldn't believe how many tanks I've got. Got like 1 million tanks. 1 million sniper rifles. But no fucking Phaetons. I love Phaetons. They're like super broke. I wonder what's in these barrels. Ah, I hate hip fire. So shit. Yeah, I wonder what's in these barrels. Wine, maybe? Whiskey? It's a lot of that, but that would be a lot of whiskey. I'm running out of room. There's the chessboard. Did I use my... Yeah, I used my rifle upgrade. I would still like to kill the wasp nest, but, well, not wasp nest, but you know what I mean. Probably blood barrels. Maybe. That'd be kind of weird, though. Okay. I want to try and get through here without using too much ammo. Grenade's probably going to be the way to go. Right. Come on, bitches. Wake up. Time to work. There is always one.
Follow.
There's always a wise guy. Always.
Can you just put that in the other one? I really can't believe I forgot that. Oh no, I've already got the green one, haven't I? Actually missing quite a bit of treasure. Remember how much money you get from I forgot the free rocket launcher too, but I don't really have any room for that. Goddamn snake. I can't wait to play the Twin Snakes again, but I need to get my 360 out of the way for that. Freaking the GameCube's too tall for my unit. Like, I have a unit where I keep all my systems, and they all fit perfectly. The one system that doesn't fit, the goddamn GameCube, because it's so tall. So I need to get rid of one first.
Wait.
But I've been watching Metal Gear Scanlan, the Giant Bomb playthrough, and that's just really got me in the mood to play Metal Gear 1. I haven't played that in probably over 10 years. I played the Twin Snakes when it came out, and it was one of those, like, really... sort of, I don't know what the word is, but I really regretted not buying it when it came out, because I didn't buy it when it came out, and I could have got it for, like, you know what, I think it was £30 when it first came out, the Twin Snakes, because I think it was actually a limited release. I don't think they made many copies of that, because it's super rare now. And I remember, I think it was like 2 or 3 years ago, I paid about £70 for a copy of that game. About 70 quid for a GameCube copy. And I could have just bought it when it came out for 30. Ended up paying double the amount for it. The same thing happened with the GameCube releases of RE2 and 3. When they came out, they were 20 quid. I ended up paying, I think, like 30, like over 30 for both of those. So like 70 across both versions because they were so rare. Which led me to buy a copy of... I bought the PS3 copy of Deadly Premonition this week for that exact reason. I managed to find that for, I think it was 16 or 17 quid. I managed to get a copy of that. And because already, like, people are trying to flog that for, like, upwards of 50 quid on PS3. Because I don't think there's a great deal of them floating around. And Deadly Premonition is fucking awesome. And the PS3 version's got all the extra shit, too. So I'm definitely going to play that. I was thinking of streaming it, but with how often I'd get to play it and how long that game is, it'd probably take me like a year to actually finish that game. Which sucks, but... Oh, thanks for the host, Farrah. That's very kind of you. Thank you. But I really do love Deadly Premonition. It's a piece of shit as a game. Like, as a game, is Deadly Premonition any good? After I say it's a piece of shit. As a game, it's terrible. Like, there's no getting around that. Like, you know, like, it's really... It looks really bad. Like, the graphics are crappy. Mechanics are crappy. But there's just... It's such a hard game to describe. You know, the story is why you play that game. You know, it's... You just gotta play it. With how cheap you can probably find the 360 version now as well, like, just pick it up, man. Because I find that if you really talk up Deadly Premonition to somebody, you know, they'll probably go into it with higher expectations than they should have. So, just play it is the best recommendation for that game. Just play it. It's just really... really surreal. It's kind of like this last generation's Eternal Darkness is the best comparison I can think of. Hey, Ferret, what's up, dude? Thanks for the host, man. That's cool. But Eternal Darkness was a more solid game, for sure. Like, Eternal Darkness was pretty sound for the most part, but that's kind of the closest comparison I can think of is Eternal Darkness. And even that's, to be honest, pretty... It's a bit of a stretch, to be honest.
Oh, thanks for the host, Faye. But yeah, there is nothing like Deadly Premonition. Absolutely nothing like that game. That was another one I bought just because of the cover, too. I thought the cover was interesting. I remember I rented that from Blockbuster. Shoutouts to Blockbuster. And I had it for a week. And I remember I played it. I played it when I got it. I got home and played it. And it starts off like fairly typical survival horror kind of setup. And then after that, I didn't play it for about 2 or 3 days because of work. And then I played it again and got really hooked on it. I was like, damn, I need this game. And I kept it until after the rental and then took the game back. I think it was probably, it would have been a weekend at the time. And I took the game back and then immediately just like picked up a copy off the shelf and bought it straight away. It's like, I need to finish this game. And then went home and finished it over the course of the next couple of weeks. It's a long game too. It's a very long game. Even if you just kind of stick straight to the story stuff. Don't shoot me. Yeah, you missed. I'm awesome. Yeah, even if you just stick to just the story stuff, it's fairly long. But if you do like all the optional stuff and really, you know, kind of really make the most of the game, that is a... I think my first playthrough was about 50 hours, I think. It's a very, very long game. Ah, shit. There's too many people in here. Run away. I was kind of hoping you'd throw that, because it'd miss me. That twat throwing bombs, man. How many rifle shots have I got? Ah, bollocks. Okay, that's going to take 15 off me to reload. Yeah, and that should be enough to get me through this and kill the Garadors. I love how sometimes their hand is just still there, like, after you blow that off with that. Right. Don't want any of you. Leave me alone. Right. Okay. I've not got a lot of health here. Ah! Fuck. Okay, I've already put a shot on him. Weird how that doesn't tip them off. Right. This is another segment, man. Like, if this segment goes bad, it goes really bad. Absolute cock. Now these guys show up. I'm surprised that didn't hit. There's no way to kick these helmet guys either. Where the fuck is the other guy? Shit. Yeah, I did, Pharaoh. Yeah, I did. That's what I was trying to do with that first guy, but he fucking ran at me. Fuck off. Well, this is going well. Fuck off. Shit. Ah, you son of a bitch. Yeah, that first guy, I was hoping he would carry on walking towards me. And I was going to knife him in the face and use him to kick down one of the Garadors. And that would have been all I needed. But he didn't do that because he's a dick. Right. Let's try that again. You absolute bitch. No, I didn't want to do that. No. Fucking Xbox. Okay. No. I did not want to hit the fucking guide button. Stupid thing. They're both coming at me. Shit. Yeah, that does kind of suck for you. This bit would kind of be too easy, though, if they did that. But you should be able to get a silencer for your sniper rifle. Let's try and lure these guys down here, actually. Unless they have dynamite. Well, that kind of had the desired effect. They take the same amount of shots, if I remember rightly. Right, so that's two on that guy. Ah, you fucking dick! Get off me. Right, okay. So he should come right for me. Whee! That's one down. That's two shots on him, I think. I'm gonna take that Morningstar, and I'm gonna do bad things to you with it. You son of a bitch! I hate this bit. I hate this bit when you don't have a shotgun. Fucking legs. Really? I shot somebody right in front of you. And you don't hear that? This should be dead. Yes. Whew. Man, that took like way too many shots. Took way too many rifle rounds. Man. Hang on a minute. I might need to... Can I fit a rocket launcher in here? I don't think I can. That's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, I'll... I need to do some... Do some item management. But first. Oh my god! That's one of the only ones in the game where I think, like, nobody can fail that quick time event, surely. It was fair. I mean, that was a piece of cake. Yeah. Incendiary. Right, okay.
Welcome. Got some rare. Things on sale, stranger.
I tried to stream NGS a while ago, but streams disappeared. Connected the PS3 to a splitter as usual. All the games work NGS. That's a good question, Chris. I don't know. Usually, when I stream the PS3, I have to go composite to stream it because I don't have a splitter that can get around the HDMI. You know, whatchamacallit thingy. What's it? What the hell is that thing called? The pass-through protection, where like it basically won't let you record or put a pass-through on the HDMI. So I always have to record composite. So I don't actually get that problem, but it means I can only stream in like 576p, which sucks. But no, I've not heard of that. I know of a few people that are able to record PS3, like, you know, with HDMI, and it's okay. That's it, Chris. Yeah, HDCP. Is it like high something copy protection or something? But yeah, you have got a lot of options on the PS3. You can use like secondary sound because you actually have a dedicated sound output, I think, on the PS3. Right, what am I doing? I'm waffling on here.
What are you selling? Is that all? Is that all strength? Is that all?
Alright, sell all this shit. Let's reload this. That'll get rid of some. That'll clear some space. I need 8 slots. I'd need to sell 3 incendiaries. Yeah. Hang on, no, I could reload. No, I need to clear 3 item blocks out. So yeah, I'll sell 3 incendiaries. I'll gamble. I was trying to save up the 10 for it, but Verdugo would take like pretty much all my fucking ammo off me right now to kill him. So we are gonna mess him up. Although, I did actually find a knife strategy for Verdugo recently. But fuck that, because it literally takes about 25 minutes to kill him. So, no sir. Right. I'm going to see if I can come back here and pick that up, because I kind of need that. But I really wish the PS3 didn't have that. It's really annoying. I understand why they do it, because if they didn't, like, you'd just be able to straight up pirate, like, Blu-rays and shit, like, really, really easily. And, you know, they fixed it on the PS4, but it's just a pain in the ass. You know, like, capturing and, you know, people making game videos and that is, it's super common, so just make it easy. Which, you know, this generation, to be fair, they have. They're not the triggers I'm using, so I'm a rebel. I'm using a 360 pad. I ain't using your Xbox One pad. I'd like to be. Even though it actually sucks for this game, because the dead zones are way off on the controls. Gonna mess this dude up. Frame rate. Oh my god. 24 frames a second. It's so cinematic. Man, my poor incendiary stash. A few months ago, I had some major sound issues with streaming directly from Xbox One to Twitch. That's one of the main reasons I don't stream through the actual consoles. On the PS4, you have to use the shitty PS4 mic, which sounds like turd. And I actually haven't tried it on the Xbox, to be honest, but with how sluggish the Xbox interface is with everything else, I can't imagine it much, much better for streaming. So I just use my Elgato for that. And I got half of mine to get the new one, but for now, like, I still need it to record, you know, composite stuff like old systems and that. And I'm pretty sure the new, like, 60fps Elgato doesn't actually support any composite input. So I wouldn't be able to stream like any old games anymore. And I like streaming old games when I have the time. Oh no, I can't go back this way. Poop. It might be an NGS issue, I don't know. But yeah, like the recording from the PS3 was always a bit of a headache. I never bothered with it all that much. Isn't there TMP ammo in here? Oh no, there's an extra cylinder in here. But right, yeah, that's the castle done. No more castle. Making good progress. Oh, man. Those deaths, though, they sucked. Fucking Garadors. Cheap bastards. Right. I've got a bit of space now, though. I just thought I might use a rocket launcher on the whatchamacallits as well. Because those trolls are fucking tanks. They take so much damage. And I haven't got that much left to do until I get to the island. And then once I get to the island, I'm pretty much home free. So, right, what have I got? Should have a rifle upgrade, I think. Oh no. Okay. I don't have that. I don't think I get that until like the end of this segment. You have to wait ages for that one. All right, yeah, we'll be cheap.
Is that all?
We will rocket launcher this bitch. I need to sell. I can sell a first aid spray. I always used to call this bit the mines, Pharaoh. This is kind of, I always just called this bit the mines. For me, it's like village, castle, mines, and then the island. That's kind of how I always used to refer to the chapters, pretty much. What am I doing? Need to sell some shit. What do I think of Resident Evil 7? Do I think it will be good? No, I don't, to be perfectly blunt. I think that looks like a steaming pile of shit. Yeah, I think that looks like absolute trash. That I don't know why they are doing. I don't know why they're going that way with it, to be honest. There's something really kind of depressing about Resident Evil trying to be, you know, the. I don't know, man. That just looked like shit. I hated that trailer. Like, it reminded me of like all these, just. You know, these dime a dozen horror indie games where it's like, hey, no context, shadows, a creepy thing, you're scared, right? No, I'm not scared. Like, that's not horror, dude. Like, Bioshock has more horror in it than that. Oh shit, I still need to sell something. Let's sell these then. 37. I mean, I could be wrong, but that doesn't look very good to me at all. And I think at this point, like, Resident Evil, I don't think even Capcom know what to do with it anymore. It's a huge franchise for them, like, you know, but I think they just don't know what to do with it anymore. The last really good Resident Evil game was 5, and even that, you know, it didn't live up to what I think it needed, though. That's true, but Silent Hill, I think, always did a better job at actually, you know, contextualizing what was happening. You know, like, a lot of the sort of indie horror stuff is, you know, there's absolutely no setup for it, so you don't really know if anything's, like, really happening. It was my big problem that I had with The Evil Within. You know, it starts off trying to be, like, you know, super realistic and immersive. Oh, shit. How did that not kill me? No, I'm not complaining. I'm not actually going to use my first aid spray here. But yeah, that started off trying to be realistic, and then it just goes into, like, such a game. And it's like, wait, the disconnect on The Evil Within was ridiculous for me. I really didn't enjoy that. And it was also annoying how I felt, you know, the whole thing was, you know, the return to survival horror, blah, 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 blah. And literally within the first half an hour of that game, you're in a creepy village with a guy with a sack on his head chasing after you with a chainsaw. Ah, you son of a bitch. I'm dead. You see, I shouldn't have started getting off on a rant. But yeah, like, within the first half an hour, it's like a fucking next-gen upgrade with garbage gameplay of RE4. And man, what a bill. What just total bill of goods, that game. But yeah, I love Silent Hill. Like, Silent Hill 1 through 3 are my main ones for that. I did play a little bit of 4, but then just didn't really keep up with the series. So, but yeah, 1 through 3, fantastic. Oh, 6 was fucking terrible, wasn't it? Resident Evil 6, man, ugh. Weird example of, like, how a game that is actually not that bad, like, mechanically, like, it's pretty solid, but, you know, it just doesn't know what it wants to be. You know, like, does it want to be a third-person shooter? Does it want to be a horror game? Does it want to be, like, an army game with monsters? Like, it just seemed like it had no focus at all, and I think that really hurt it. And even though it wasn't bad, you know, quote-unquote, mechanically, it wasn't particularly good either. Like, you know, the best thing you could say, I think, was that everything worked, and that was about it. Other than that, it wasn't great. Leave me alone! This is close. I shot that. Come on. Fucker. In my opinion, Resident Evil went down after 4. I agree with you, Faye. I do really like RE5, but RE5 is no RE4. Let's be serious here. Call it Resident Evil. That's actually not bad. Resident of Evil Duty. That could work too. But yeah, I really do like 5, but 5 is nothing compared to 4. And the main reason I liked 5 was just the Mercenaries mode. I think Mercenaries mode in 5 was amazing. They really, really nailed Mercenary mode in 5. And I love, like, score chasing and stuff. So that was a pretty personal thing for me. But I will take 5 a million times over 6, you know. Right, okay, let's concentrate here. Let's focus. Can I jump down, please? Thank you. Even the story stuff they tried to do in Resident Evil 6 was a bit whatever, too. Like, supposedly it was supposed to wrap everything up, and I can't even remember most of what happened in that game. Boom! Don't explode! Alright. Oh my god, this frame rate is terrible. There we go. Right. Oh, the bug cave. Yay. I love that bit. I love it. In the same way I love getting hit in the face. Alright, let's get us out of the way. I think I played my last run at this really slow. I don't remember this being as tough. Now you see that right there? They were both standing on that. That should have killed both of them. But you actually can't do that, which sucks because you should be able to. Boom! Take that. I played a bit of The Evil Within and thought it felt a bit exciting. Turned out to be an arcade cheap RE4 clone, yeah. I actually would have carried on playing The Evil Within, but I got a like truly game-breaking glitch in, I think it was like chapter 3 or something, where every time I loaded my game, my character just fell through the floor and like I couldn't do anything. Like I couldn't get out of that. So there was no way I was going to start all over again because I didn't really enjoy it that much. It was a shame because I was really hoping that game would, you know, would actually bring back some horror. And instead it was just a total bill. I did not know you could go back in here. Where's that chainsaw guy? There he is. All right. There's a hand grenade. Yeah, give me that. Fuck off. But yeah, horror. It's hard to do, man. There's not many horror games around now. It's just... I don't know. Have people just forgot how to make horror games? I think there's a notion of what horror is. And it's just, as I said, for the most part, it seems to be creepy hallways with books in them and cobwebs with a jump scare every 5 minutes. That ain't horror. My book. Any game can do that. Jump scares pretty much across the board aren't horror, you know? Like anybody can be jump scared. It's not hard. You know, like creating an atmosphere where you are genuinely frightened to go forward. That's a whole different ballgame, you know? That's really hard to do. Like, the old Resident Evils had that for me. Granted, I was a kid when I played them, but... Even, like, the remake, you know, it's spooky, you know? It's a spooky game. Yeah. You absolute dicks. Oh, fuck. Ah, I missed my kick prompt. Oh, now I'm dead. What am I doing? What am I doing? Yeah, that's old controls. Fucking bastard. I'd like another Alan Wake game. Yeah, I loved Alan Wake. That was really good. That was, I don't know, like, well, I suppose, like, the older you get, it is harder to get scared. But, like, that was very atmospheric. That was really spooky. I like that. I think spooky's a good word for, you know, a feeling of horror, you know. But, I mean, Alan Wake was good, but I don't know if they'll, do another one. I don't think it did very well, from what I remember. Like, it did okay, but I think with the development cycle it had, it needed to do a lot better than okay for it to be, you know, a success, and I don't think it did that. Ah, these fucking bugs. I hate this bit. I hate this bit anyway, but this bit without a shotgun, I really, really hate it. Yeah, jump scares with the build-up, yeah, that's fine, you know? Like, when there's tension and there's a jump scare, like, Dead Space does that pretty well, you know? It's like, you know shit is about to go down in Dead Space. You fucking bitch. Oh, okay, maybe this'll work? No, it didn't work. Don't hit me. I hate this bit. This bit is so gay without a shotgun. Any news on new Ninja Gaiden? I don't think so, man. I don't know. I don't know if they're actually doing anything with it. The last one, I keep forgetting, but the last one was that that Yaiba game. Was it Yaiba or something? Like Ninja Gaiden Z, basically. That was the last one, and as far as I know, that was like a massive flop. Like, you know, everybody hated it. It didn't sell. You know, obviously didn't do the Ninja Gaiden name. Ow, Windows 10, that was my ear that you just, like, fucking updated me in. Well, that was really loud. I don't think it did very well. Obviously reviewed terribly. So, you know, wouldn't hold your breath for a new Ninja Gaiden game. But at this point, who gives a shit, you know? The good people aren't there anymore. And the best thing they could do is just do like an HD remaster of Black, in my opinion. I really think that is the best thing they could do for that series. Right, I think that's the key. I'm gonna have to fight more of these guys than I actually want to. I wonder if you can, like, one-shot them with the TMP, because that would be fucking awesome. Nah. Ah, you fucking... I absolutely fucking hate this bit. Oh. Well, kind of got me out. Ah, you bastard. Am I dead? Oh, not quite. I think I am now, though. Yeah. Like, that trick, like, it's good when it works, but when it doesn't work, it's so infuriating. That guy just going nuts. Right, I'm gonna try something pretty, that kinda worked. Reload. Okay, that worked, kind of. Took all my fucking ammo, but hey. Let's go. Alright, come on, you bitches. I've got no ammo. You go in the air. Oh man, I've got the minecart coming up. I really can't go in the minecart without any fucking ammo. rifle ammo? Are you kidding me? Right, to buy it here would really suck. Let me get out of here. I really do need ammo, so I'm gonna... That is TMP ammo, but I'm, like, totally not gonna be able to get to that. And this is probably taking more ammo than it's giving me. Did that get him in the head? You bastard. Well, bugger me. That actually worked. Man, I need to catch up with this stream. Alan Wake teaser and Quant. Oh, was there? I did not know that. Yeah, Dead Space 1 and 2 are great, man. 3 is good too, but it's not as good as 1 and 2. When is the Dead or Alive X3 stream? I didn't even... Is there that many of those games? But you know what? There probably is. Wasn't the... Yeah, I think there is. Wasn't the latest one the one people freaked out about? Which is kind of funny, seeing as those games have been going, like, forever. And, you know... It's just shameless headline grab where people can be like, oh my god, this game is so inappropriate, man. It's like, come on, dude. Get with it. At least get with the times, if you're going to complain. You know, at least complain about something at least modern. Like, I was going to say GTA, but complaining about GTA isn't really modern anymore. That got old with, like, Jack Thompson. Just under 3 hours. Yeah, this is a fairly quick run for me. I'd usually be at, like, anywhere from 4 to 5 hours at this point. Right, plus side. It didn't take any of my incendiaries off me, or any more, and I actually managed to get a pretty decent amount of health out of it. But holy crap. I did not enjoy that. Yeah, they really do. That I couldn't agree more, man. That's why I think the best thing they could do in a lot of ways is just put out an HD edition of Black with the Hurricane Packs, because then, you know, it's far enough removed now where you have this whole new group of people that, you know, supposedly love hard games. You've got the Dark Souls crowd to kind of appeal to, you know? Like, you could even put it right in the trailer. If you think Dark Souls is hard, like, you haven't seen shit until you play NG. That's right in the trailer. That's free advertising. So I think that's a good thing they could do, and then that would get people, you know, talking about the game in a positive light. The game hasn't really aged mechanically at all, because it hasn't really been surpassed yet, so it would do pretty well, would probably review really well. It would probably be really good in, like, the streaming scene, because you'd get all these scrubs streaming it, getting bodied. And, you know, everybody would love to watch that because it'd make them feel better about themselves. And then, you know, it would put NG in a good place again. But all the while, the last NG thing is either NG3 or whatever that Yiba thing was. No one's going to touch it with a barge pole. So, you know, they need to put out something good with the NG name on it. But even then, you know, there's no guarantee. Legs. There we go. One more crank, really. I would kind of enjoy that, though. As much as that would be somewhat frustrating, but it would be funny to see, like, you know, a whole new age of people just get fucked by Mirai, like, on stream. That would be hilarious. Because you know the complaints that would come, like, oh, this guy is not fair, you can't do anything. Ooh, that was close. You're on fire. I have a flame sword. Ooh, this bit's gonna be tricky. I really need more TMP ammo. fucking bugs, man. Oh, that hurt. That hip fire, man. So shitty. Yeah, but it's true, Fire. I couldn't agree more. Like it's a shame that NG has got to that point. It really has. Because, I mean, NG2, like, you know, wasn't bad, you know? Like, I think NG2 gets a bit of a bad rap. All right, Chris. Thanks for the host, man. I'll catch you later, man. But, yeah, like, I think NG2 gets a bad rap. And, you know... The fault of that game was the hardware at the time, really. You know, it was way too much for the 360. The 360 just couldn't handle that game. Which is why I'd love for them to update it. Like, playing NG2 at rock solid 60 with, like, no drops, just... God, that gets me, like, slightly aroused thinking about that. Like, I would love to play that. But you can't, like, and that's why it's such a shame, because when NG2 is running properly and everything's working and the frame rate's not shitting itself, nothing compares to that game. There is not an action game on the planet, even NGB, that compares to NG2 when everything is working. But it's only working about 3% of the time, so, you know, doesn't really mean much, you know. It's like having an emergency parachute that only works 3% of the time. You know, not really all that good. Right. I still hardly have any goddamn money. Yeah, it was. NG, I mean, that's the one thing about NG2. It's like, that game was pretty goddamn hard. But in a cheap way, I think. NG2 is more broken than NGB. You know, like, if you, once you know kind of all the, you know, the little tricks of NG2, like, it's not actually that hard. Why are you giving me fucking handgun ammo when I don't have a handgun? Get off my shit. I'll actually use my rifle here. Fuck it. Using my rifle here is probably not the best idea. Have to time this well. Come on, Wood. Where are you? Save me. Wait. Right, I kind of want that money. You fucker. Okay, that bit went okay. Ooh, well, hey, 100 TMP rounds. Sick. QuickTime event still makes me really tense. Always used to fail it on the fucking PC version. Man, that was a pretty good minecart ride. For like no shotgun. That was pretty good. God, I really hope I get lucky with incendiary grenade drops. I can think of three more off the top of my head that are guaranteed before I get to it. So I need to get two more. I need to get two kind of just on the fly. I need to get lucky and just get two from random drops. Which is, you know, not impossible. But I'll have to save up some rifle ammo as a backup. Or, actually, would it be more efficient to just rocket launcher him? It probably would be. Although I haven't got a lot of money. I just remembered, I'm sitting on, like, a shitload of treasure, aren't I? I can't be arsed to do this, but I just can't be bothered. I want to play some Dust. Right, okay, yeah, I've got a lot of treasure, so I'm actually okay for money. I didn't get a blue eye, did I? Piece of shit. Right, okay, so that's good. Got the full crown. Yeah, I'm actually doing fine for money. That's no problem at all. So let's do this. We'll put in a save, and we'll tackle this bitch tomorrow. How we doing? Yeah, it probably would have been a lot easier on myself to just abandon grenades and use that space for ammo. Because hoarding all these grenades is why I haven't had a lot of space. And that's made certain bits pretty difficult. So you live and learn. Anyway, I will save again. Why not? We don't need no ink ribbon to save in this game. Not anymore. Right. Oh, man. That is going to do it for this one. This room's going well. Should be able to wrap this up on the next one. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Appreciate the hosts and appreciate the views. I will catch you tomorrow, hopefully. Peace.